Welcome to the ACE1000 Quick Guide video series. And today I will show you how to access the ACE1000 unit web interface for both the FEP and RTU. The ACE1000 and ACE1100 units, the RTU and FEP accordingly, have a web interface which should be used to configure the unit when setting up a new system. The term new system refers to an ACE1000 system which is not combined with the ACE3600 RTUs. The mixed system scenario will be discussed in a different video. One of the main differences between the two systems is the configuration method. The new system is configured via a web interface, while the mixed system is configured via the ACE3600 System Tools Suite, or in short, STS. What we'll need for this video is a laptop or desktop machine, an ACE1000 unit, which could be either an RTU or FEP unit, the power supply to power up the ACE1000 unit, and a micro USB cable. As you can imagine, I've already prepared the setup here on my desk. I powered the unit and waited for it to complete its power up. Once the unit completed its power up, I used the command prompt window to verify my connectivity with the unit via ping, as described in the previous video. To access the web interface, I will now open a Chrome web browser and I will input onto the address bar https://192.168.9.9. Then I will press the Enter key. As you can see, the Chrome browser will indicate that the connection is not private, thus prompting the user to continue to the web interface by clicking the underlined advanced link, then by clicking the underlined proceed to 192.168.9.9 web. Once they click, the ACE1000 web interface will appear. As you can see now, the login window appears, and in it, we will have to input the username and password to be granted access to the web interface. I will only say that the username is admin, but as for the password, please open the ACE1000 Easy Configuration User Guide PDF document and go to Appendix G, the ACE1000 Credentials, where you will find the appropriate password. Once entering the password and pressing the login button, the configuration and monitoring web interface will appear. Please note that the same procedure applies to both FEP and RTU. However, the FEP web interface will hold information on the whole system, whereas the RTU web interface will hold information only for that specific RTU. I would like to thank you for watching this video. I hope you have enjoyed it and gained some new knowledge during this time. Thank you. Bye-bye.